In today's video, we're going to take a look at what's new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here or you find it helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 18. So I'm in Safari here, and I'm looking at an article from CNN. Now, for the most part, what has changed here with Safari is located under the page menu. This is where basically all of the different options have changed. They redesigned this page menu. So what is this page menu? Well, basically, when we tap on it, we're going to have a number of different options in here. And they reorganize this to make things a little bit easier. And we can also customize this. So let's go through some of these options here. The first thing is we can listen to the page. When I tap on this, what it'll do is it'll actually read the page to me. In addition to that, I can also go directly into reader mode. This is going to strip out the ads. Let's go ahead and tap on that. And you're going to see it strips out the ads. I can easily read it. Now, when you're in the reader mode, and you go back over to your page view options, you're going to have some new options because I'm in reader mode. So I just tap on it. And then from here, I can change the font. I can change the background color. And once again, I can go and listen to this page, have the iPhone read it to me. And if I want to go back into my other view, out of the reader view, I can also just tap on the blue button, hide reader. And now we're back at our regular page. It is no longer in reader view. Let's go back over to our little button here. So I tap on it. Another option we have here, which is one of my favorite options here, is hide distracting items. What we're now able to do is tap on a distracting item on a web page and hide it. What do I mean by that? Well, let's go back over to my web page here. So I'm looking at my page here. And if we look up towards the top here, we have this giant banner that's taken up half of my iPhone. I would like to hide that. Well, that's what hide distracting items does. This is a distracting item for me. So let's go ahead and hide that. To do that, we go back over to our page view options. And then all we have to do is just tap on hide distracting items. It's going to go into a different mode here where I can select the distracting item. So I'm going to tap on it. And now I tap on the distracting item. That's this right up here. You're going to see that it now says hide. And when I tap on hide, you're going to see a nice little animation and it's going to hide that. So let's go ahead and do that. And you can see it hit it. Let's go ahead and hide this ad here. Again, I tap on it. You're going to see it says hide. And now that is hidden. When I am done, we are not complete yet. Now we have to tell Safari to go back into its regular mode. I went and hit all the distracting items. So now what I need to do is I need to tap on done down at the bottom here. And when I do, it's going to apply those changes, and now we can see those distracting items are hidden. Where I've used this on my personal computer is for Google login. We've all seen those Google logins appearing on more web pages. That gets to be a little distracting. I don't log into every site with that Google login. Well, now what we're able to do is hide that. We just go down to the page icon and hide that distracting item. Let's go back over to our page view options and see what else we have. Tap on it. If I want to show the hidden items again, maybe I do want to log into Google there, I can go and show that hidden item again. And then we also have turn on content blockers. So if you're using extensions that block your content, you can go and turn those on and off easily from this page menu. Now below that, we also have manage extensions. We're able to download extensions such as ad blockers, and we can manage those right from here. And then down at the bottom left corner, you're going to see we have this little icon here. This is how we can find something on a web page. It's not going to search the web, but what it will do is it will search the web page. So let's say I'm looking for something on this page. What I would do is I would tap on that, and then from here, I just type in what I'm searching for, and it's going to search that specific web page. I'm going to tap on done, and we're going to go back over to our page menu option here. We can also change the text size, of course. This is nothing new. And if we go over to the right, you're going to see we have this little ellipsis. This gives us more options. So from here, when I tap on it, what I'm able to do is I'm able to view the privacy report. I can hide the toolbar. I can also print this. In addition to that, I can also add to favorites, add it as a bookmark, move to a tab group, add to a reading list. And then, down towards the bottom, we have website-specific settings. So for this particular website, which is CNN, do I want it to use Reader automatically? I do want it to use Reader automatically when I read an article. So I'm just going to turn that on. And now when it detects that there's an article and I'm on CNN, it's going to go into Reader mode automatically. And it's only going to do this for CNN, not for any other site. So these are app-specific sites. And then, of course, we have our privacy options down here as well. And that is for the site as well, for that specific site. Now, in addition to that, we can also add some of these options as favorites. What do I mean by that? Well, when we go back over to, I'm going to tap on Done up here. When we go back over to our page view options here, I'm going to hide the reader. I'm looking at my page view options. What we're able to do is add options right in this area here. So let's say I use the reading list quite a bit. So instead of tapping on the ellipsis here and then going to add to reading list, what I'm able to do is add this directly to that first page. To do that, we just tap on edit here. And then you're going to see the little plus here. So I just tap on the green plus. It adds it to my favorites up here. And now when I go back, I'm going to tap on done up here. When I go back, you're going to see that when I'm looking at my main page view here, you're going to see that I have add to reading list. I no longer need to tap on these three dots. I can directly access it from this first page. So we're able to customize this page view as well. So those are primarily the new options that we have, and it's all located under that page view. I'm going to show you one other thing that we can do. Now, this is for people that have Apple Intelligence. So you're going to have one of the newer phones in order to do this. But what we can do is we can have Safari also summarize the web page for us that we have on our iPhone. And this is all done through Apple Intelligence. So the first thing that I need to do is I need to turn on Apple Intelligence. So I'm just going to go to my settings here. And I swipe up. I have an iPhone 15 here, so I have Apple Intelligence. I'm going to go turn this on. And when I do, and we go back over to Safari, I'm going to have another option when I'm in Reader View. So now I'm going to go back to Safari here, and we're going to go into Reader View here. And you're going to see that I have a new option. What I'm able to do is summarize this article. So now when I tap on this, what the iPhone will do, and it does this all on device, it's going to read this article and give me a summary for it. So let's go ahead and tap on it. It's reading the article, and you're going to see that I have a nice summary here. If this was a longer article, I would even have a table of contents as well, so then I could tap on different sections within the article. And that's all done with Apple Intelligence. So that is what is new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 18. Primarily, it's just a redesigned page view that makes the tools easier to access, and we can also customize them. And if you use an Apple Intelligence, if you have an iPhone with Apple Intelligence, we can also get a summary of any article when it's in Reader View. So that is what's new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, you can share it with your friends and family. But even more than that, what you may want to do is check out my site, danstutorials.com. I've been creating videos for over a decade, and even though I have over 400 of them on YouTube, I have over 2,100 of them on my site, Dan's Tutorials. So how can you help support my efforts in creating these videos? Well, my site is a membership-based site. And when you become a member, I will strip out all of the ads in the video, so you're not going to see any of those pesky ads. You also get access to my AI assistant, which is modeled after an Apple genius. And I host webinars and classes on a regular basis, and you have access to those as well. But even more than that, you are also helping support a small business. It's just me sitting in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some big corporation or anything like that. And when you become a member, you are helping support my efforts in creating these videos. So if you want to learn more, check out danstutorials.com, and thank you for watching.